Praise God. Prayer requests, we'll just lift our hands up. If y'all have prayer requests, we're going to open up the service with prayer and pray for those that are sick, those that are not here. Praise God. All right, let's all stand. How many's looking for a move of the Holy Ghost tonight?
Amen.
Amen. I'm excited. I've been excited all week. I was out here kind of cutting the grass and had my headphones on all day just worshiping the Lord all by myself. So I was having a good time. So I already had church today and ready to have church again. Amen. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. God, we love you. Worship with us as we sing.
In this time of desperation, when all we know is doubt and fear, there is only one foundation. We believe, oh, we believe. In this broken generation, when all is dark, you help us see. There is only one salvation. We believe. We believe in God the Father. We believe in Jesus Christ. We believe in the Holy Spirit, and He's given us new life. We believe in the crucifixion. We believe that He conquered hell. We believe in His resurrection, and He's coming back again. We believe. Let our faith be more than anthems, greater than the songs we sing.
Oh yes, hallelujah.
In our weakness and
how many believes tonight? Hallelujah.
We believe. Oh. We believe in God the Father. We believe in Jesus Christ. We believe in the Holy Spirit, and He's given us new life. We believe in the crucifixion. We believe that He conquered hell. See, we believe, we believe, and the gates of hell will not prevail, for the power of God has torn the veil. Now we know your love will never fail. We believe, that the lost be found, oh, and the dead be raised, in the here and now, they love in vain. Let the church live loud, our God will see. We believe. We believe in the game. will not prevail, for the power of God has torn the veil. Now we know your love will never fail. We believe that the lost be found in the dead be raised.
Oh, hallelujah.
And yeah. Now their love invade. Let the church live bound. Our God will see.
We believe. I like this part.
And the gates of hell shall not prevail, for the power of God has torn the veil. Now we know your love will never fail. We believe in God the Father. We believe in Jesus Christ. We believe in the Holy Spirit, and He's given us new life. We believe in the crucifixion. We believe that He conquered hell. We believe in His resurrection, and He's coming back again. We believe. Oh, we believe. Oh, we believe. We stand here in
presence, lifting up Christ Jesus, a strong tower meant to save us, and now nothing will defeat us. We are boldly interceding for our children lost and bleeding. We'll see slavery bound to freedom, and the sick restored to healing. So we fight for those who are mourning, and take back what's been stolen. Liberation from addiction. For when we are at our weakness, your power is completed.
Faithful forever are you, God. Are you God?
Oh. You are God.
Are you God?
Oh,
are you God?
You're my mighty Redeemer.
Mighty Redeemer.
Oh, are you God? Are you God? Shield and defender.
Shield and defender.
Are you God? Oh, hallelujah. How many knows he's God? He's the King of kings and the Lord of lords. There ain't but one, and his name, Jesus Christ. And I'm glad I serve him tonight. He's worthy. He's worthy. He's worthy.
Yeah. Oh.
You got.
Hallelujah. I'm glad that through the name of Jesus Christ that our sins are washed away. Praise God. How many is thankful for that? Hallelujah. Praise God. We're glad to have everyone with us. We're going to have some songs. And so Sister Christian, get ready. Sister Brittany, get ready. Tammy and Daryl have a song. Are you guys going to practice your song? Do your song.
No, we've got to practice
that more. Okay. They got another one, though. So, but I want somebody who's on fire right now to stand up and testify. Make some noise. Come on, let me hear you. Crickets. All right, y'all don't want me to get up here. Somebody shout glory.
Glory.
Somebody shout praise him.
Praise.
Now listen, you ain't going to get behind our preacher tonight by sitting there and not getting involved. And come on, we got to get with it tonight. This is a youth service.
Come on. Come on.
We might need to have a prayer line. Might need to pray for me tonight. There's somebody.
Listen, I mowed this yard all day today and pulled. Oh, by the way, guess who came to the altar today? Jack that fell off the beanstalk off of that big weed I pulled out back. Come on, you're supposed to laugh there. So what I'm saying is I pulled weeds, I mowed, I should be tired, more tired than anybody else in here, and so should my wife. Come on.
Come on.
Somebody give him praise tonight. Give him praise. He's worthy of our praise. If he's not worthy of anything else, he's worthy of the fact that he brought you here. Amen. You're not dead. You're not pushing up daisies tonight, but you're here. Amen. Because God showed favor on you tonight. Hallelujah. I'm here because I'm ready to worship, and I'm ready to praise, and I'm ready for revival. Amen. In my soul, I want God to stir me. I want him to move. I want him to use me. I want him to shape me. I want him to mold me. Oh, hallelujah. Well, that's why I'm here. See, I'll be your cheerleader tonight. I just give me some pom-poms and we'll have church. Hallelujah. But God's been great to us.
Amen.
So somebody stand with a burning testimony of how God's greatness has been to you. Real quick, somebody. Sister Linda, she ain't even come to our church, and look at her. I like it. Right. There's no doubt in my mind. Brother Mark, we're just going to stand and testify. Amen. Praise the Lord. He's a way maker.
Amen.
Said he's a way maker.
Amen. Come on.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Well, I tell you what, Sister Brittany, come and kick off our first song. Yeah, count your blessings. That's what we want to hear. Somebody else, while she's getting ready, somebody else stand and testify. Go ahead, Stephen. All right. All right. Christian, stand and testify. Hallelujah. Bruce Cobb. Everybody say, Lord bless her. Church. Well, he's been in church, but seemed like he's been away forever. But come on up.
I want to thank God for something. I'm done schooling and trying for another job. It's got a big pay raise. That's why we do most jobs we do, paycheck. And don't know if I passed all my stuff or not. Won't know for 3 weeks. They said they're going to give me the job anyway. I thought that was real good. That's a real blessing right there. You know, God can make your way how he wants it to be. And I believe that if you've been faithful to God, then he's faithful to you. And he's been a blessing in my life. I don't believe I'd be alive if it hadn't been for the Lord.
Amen. Come on. Come on.
A lot of my classmates have hooked up with us. And we've made back connections on that Facebook. Eight of them died with cancer already. Eight out of my graduating class of 235. About another 15 have died from AIDS from my class, my school. I went to Citrus County, obviously, but about 15 have died from AIDS. Many, many, many of them have been in prison, been arrested. My good friend I ran with, we were tight. We probably, for 2 years, he stayed at my house or I stayed at his. We were together every day, school and all, year round. 26 counts of Grand Theft Auto. I thank God that I made it through. Sometimes you got to endure a little bit, but just hold on.
Amen. Amen.
The road gets rough, hold on. You know what some people try to do? When you're driving a semi and you get that thing one wheel off the road, they test you on that. That's part of the test. They take you off the road with a semi going on the highway at highway speed. The worst thing you can do is overcorrect. You got to let it ride sometimes off the road and shaking and bouncing and stable. Get yourself straightened up and then bring it back up. A lot of people think, well, I'm going to get back on track. A lot of people always going to get back on track. Ain't never been on track. But I'll tell you what, the day I came to an altar, I repented. I've been baptized in the name of Jesus Christ, filled with the Holy Ghost.
Hallelujah.
You're on track tonight. Amen.
Yes,
a lot of people, they're on the wrong track.
Hallelujah.
You can't get so focused on a goal, amen, that goal always ain't got God in it. Come on now.
Amen.
We went to church years ago in Black Oak. There was these people there. I thought the world of them, Brother Michael. I'm not sure. The name Cook seems to ring a bell, but I don't know if that was them or not. But they come in there, I thought highly of them. They was holiness people. That might not be their name. Do you know, was there Cooks there, Daryl? All right, well, I guess it was. They had a daughter or a granddaughter. Guess she's sang and everything, and oh, they got pictures of her sign given out at the church where she's going to be some big star in Nashville. Well, la-di-da. Is she in church today? I think you'd be better off knowing the Lord, amen, when you get to the end of this life's road than you will having a singing contract in Nashville, Tennessee. Can someone say praise the Lord tonight? I think you'd be better off with the Lord, amen, in a bicycle than you will without the Lord in a new car. Can someone say praise the Lord? I think you'd be better off with the Lord in a real nice Walmart tent than you would a fine mansion without the Lord at the end of this road. Can someone say praise the Lord? I don't know if you all know Brandon Jones or not. Do you know Brandon? Do you see what all he went through? Boy got meningitis 2 weeks ago, Brittany. And you know how the outcome of that is. But people prayed and prayed and prayed, and he's healed, Brother Daryl, from meningitis. I'd rather have the Lord and have meningitis than not have the Lord and have meningitis. How about you?
Amen.
Well, it don't mean nothing. It don't mean nothing. I'll tell you what, when it's you, it'll mean something. I don't know how I'd make it. Hopefully we never have to find out. But I want if I have to go through something, I want God on my side.
Amen. Yep. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
I'm encouraged tonight to see people that want to serve the Lord. It's no secret there was a shooting in a church this week. It made news. It's made news. It's made news. That boy Wright, why he wrote on the internet, there's a big thing he wrote of why he felt the way he did and did all that stuff, but Neighbor, don't be misled. Don't be deceived. Don't be confused thinking it can't happen here. It can happen anywhere. The Bible says in the last days, what's that word starts with a P? Perilous time shall come. We're looking for sometimes we trying to rebuild the church. We're going to put an offering plate in here. Hopefully some stranger come in here and mount up some $10,000 stacks of hundreds and kick and make them in the offering plate or something. That ain't happened either. The Bible didn't even tell us to expect that. It didn't tell us if you smile and you like Joel Osteen, you're going to do one bit better in this life. It says perilous time shall come. You want to know who's preaching the truth? The one that tells you perilous times shall come. It said men shall be lovers of God. Oh no, lovers of themselves, of men, of lust, of filth. These young people are going to have a hard time. And very soon, Brother Mark, they're going to learn they ain't going to be young people very long. And they're going to be pointing at them little ones, them young people. We got to encourage young people. Amen? Praise the Lord. I love the Lord for his blessings on me. I really do, and I thank everyone. And Brother Mark, I don't know if you've ever seen a church, but this is what we did with it. It's a work in progress, and I find out I'm a work in progress. Amen? And no matter what our young preacher says tonight, you get behind him and amen him because he's a work in progress. Amen?
Praise. He's still working on me to make me what I ought to be. Well, glory. How many, is he still working on you?
Amen.
Praise God. He might have to drive a nail every now and again and hit us over the head with a hammer, but he's still working on us. Praise the Lord. Brother Daryl, Sister Tammy, come sing. Praise God. Come on, Christian, come sing.
The news came to Jesus. Please come fast. Lazarus is sick, and without your help, he will not last. Mary and Martha watch their brother die. Jesus, he did not come, and they wondered why. Jesus said, Martha, show me the grave. But she said, Lord, you don't understand. He's been buried for days. The gravestone was rolled back. Then Jesus cried, Lazarus, come forth. Then somebody said, he's alive, he's alive.
He's on time. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. All right. Testify.
I thank God for being here tonight, for his many blessings on me, for supplying the needs. A couple of weeks ago, I was really sick. Well, about 3 weeks, I think it's been about now. And I didn't know what the doctor was thinking. And had I known, I'd probably have been really worried. I just knew I was sick. When it was all said and done, Lisa says, I just wanted to tell you that we thought you had leukemia because all my blood work was so, you know, crazy. I was like, thank God I don't. I said, I don't know what I would do. You know, we really don't know. Maybe I did, maybe I didn't. But when it all came out, God straightened all the blood work out by the time it was said and done. So he was 4 days late. And I thank God I didn't have that, because that would have been a terrible thing to have had in my life. And I don't know what I would have done. So I appreciate God for his healing mercies. Keep me in your prayers. I keep getting infections, I guess, because of my iron. So just pray that I'm started some iron pills today, that they'll help build my immune system back up. I'm going to sing product of my prayer. I don't know. You should know the key. You know it, right? If there's a mountain in your way, and it seems it's there to stay, don't worry, don't you fret, don't let it get you upset. God God has never failed you yet. Just take that mountain to God in prayer. He will surely meet you there. Have faith as a mustard seed, knowing you will see that mountain cast into the sea. And I see the product of my prayer, and I know he still cares. Oh, and in the good book I read, how the sparrow he feeds, I know he's watching over. Was bound by chains for preaching Jesus Christ's name. You know, some were on down the way. The church began to pray. God sent an angel by his way.
Watching over me.
for preaching Jesus Christ's name. You know, somewhere on down the way, the church began to pray. God sent an angel by His way. Oh, still they did not believe. When Rose said He is free, the one that you've been praying for, He's not buried anymore. He's standing knocking on your door. And I see the product of my prayer. And I know He still cares. Oh, when in the good book I read, how to spare.
Can see the product of our prayer.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Said, I've never seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging bread. We are a product of somebody else's prayer. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise God. Well, I want to ask Sister Linda if she will come and sing, because I know she can sing. So we're glad to have them again with us tonight. And amen. We love them boys. Love them boys. I know she's a proud mama. Brother Mark's a proud daddy.
Well, everything is gone wrong. I got my back to the wall. Satan's coming on strong. He really wants me to fall. He sends trouble my way. Well, even sickness is part of his plan. Well, by myself I won't win. So I just throw up. Yeah, I just throw up my hands and
on, somebody throw up your hands tonight. Oh, hallelujah. Nothing could go right, and all of a sudden, you throw up your hand.
Come on.
Have you ever thought about just saying, "Hey, God, it's yours. I'm giving it all to you, Lord." Amen. Hallelujah. Just throw up your hands. So next time you see me. To try that every now and again, it might work out in our good. Praise God. I just see Brittany walking down the mall in the store somewhere. Hey. Well, glory. Yeah. Her and Josh are arguing. I can see it right now. Sister Brittany.
Hey.
Praise God. Oh, man, I like that song. That'll get me going. Praise the Lord. All right. Sister Pat, would you stand and testify? She was already telling me no. Bless her, Lord.
Thank you.
You can cry all you want, sis. God bless her. Praise the Lord. Brother Nacho. Oh, we're glad you're here. Amen. Give All right. Well, we have a request. Now, this is young youth service, so nobody has to work tomorrow, and nobody's going, oh, Brother Steve does. Man. It's been a request. Come on. Another town, another place, a different crowd, a brand new stage, the spotlight's on me, I get to choose to keep it there or point it to you. I want stage to be an altar, so all the praise goes to the Father. If I get selfish and make this life all about me, Lord, please, I want my stage to be an altar. Alarm goes start the day, each child of God takes their stage. Might be at school or a job somewhere. This world could change if this was our prayer. I want my stage to be an altar, praise goes to the Father. If I get selfish and make this life all about me, Lord, please, I want my stage to be an altar. Some perform to thousands and some to just a few, but numbers are how our little lives were such a big part of Jesus' plan. I want my stage to be an altar, so
Stage to be an altar. I want my stage to be an altar, so all the praise goes to the Father.
If I get selfish and make this life all about me, Lord, please,
I want my stage to be an altar.
As I kneel in the darkness, in the middle of the night, well, I'm praying for assurance, everything's gonna be alright. And Lord, I see another valley, it's right in front of me. Well, I'm afraid I won't be able, and I'll go down in defeat. And he said, I walked on the water, and I calmed the raging seas. Well, I spoke to the wind, it hushed, and I gave you peace. And then I run to your rescue, then I hear you when you call. Well, I walked right beside you just so you wouldn't fall. And then I leave all of heaven just to die for your sins. Well, I searched until I found you, and I'd do it all again. And now she's talking to her father in a house that once was home. She said, my bills are coming due, Lord, but 6 days is not that long. She hears a voice so still and whole that said, I'll move like that before. And I'll do this little thing, and I'd give you so much more. And he said, I walked on the water, and I calmed the raging seas. Well, I spoke to the wind, it hushed, and I gave you peace. And then I run to your rescue, then I hear you when you call. Well, I walked right beside you just so you wouldn't fall. And then I leave all of heaven just to die for your sins. Well, I searched until I found you, and I'd do it all again. He said, do you remember, oh, where I brought you from? And just take a look behind you and how far you have come. And every time you ask me, oh, did I deliver you? And so why would you be thinking that I would see you through? And he said, I walked on the water, and I calmed the raging seas. Well, I spoke to the wind, it hushed, and I gave you peace. And then I run to your rescue, then I hear you when you call. Well, I walked right beside you just so you wouldn't fall. And then I leave all of heaven just to die for your sins. Well, I searched until I found you, and I'd do it all again. Oh, I searched until I found you, and I'd do it all again.
can use who he wants to use. And I'm glad that these young people are playing and singing for the Lord. Amen. Throughout my years, I've watched God-given talents just go right down the drain. Amen. But I'm so thankful that there's still those few that are still holding on, and they'll use their abilities and their talents for the Lord. Amen. I believe they'll be tremendously blessed, and I can see it come to fruition. We got a special speaker, if y'all don't know him by now. I know him. Come here, Mark. Come on. This boy, he's good. He's real good. He's special. I got home from working at the church today, went in there, took my watch off, and getting ready to hop in the shower, and there lies on my bed a tackle box. Now, this is a boy after my own heart. Him and my daughter got me a Father's Day gift. I don't know if that's a hint or something, but well, you keep taking me, and we'll go. You can keep teaching me, and I'll keep having fun. Amen. But I do, in all seriousness, I do appreciate the Lord for Brother Mark. And you know what? And I said it last week, I believe, or a week before. There's one thing that this church will do is we'll uphold our young ministers. If they feel the call of God, who are we to tell them they don't? As long as they've sought, you know, the Bible says to make your callings and election sure. Amen. Praise God. And you know what? If they feel the call of the Lord, I can't tell him, Brother Mark or Brother Paul or anybody else, what the will of God is for them. How many have seen people try to tell you what the will of God is for you? Okay, well, how come God ain't told me? Amen, right? But I appreciate the Lord. I appreciate Brother Mark, and he's allowing the Lord to use him, and he's using him. I believe God's going to use him in a greater and a mightier way. How about you? I believe he's going to do that with all of our young ministers. I can't tell you how proud I am of Brother Paul, how far he's come in the ministry. And God is going to continue to use them as long as they'll allow God. And you know what? As long as I'm here, I'm going to help them succeed. Amen. Amen. It took somebody to help me come along. Praise God. You know, I'm not getting any younger. I'm still young, though, but I'm not getting any younger. And they're coming right up behind our trail. And I appreciate him. I thank him for his desire to serve God. And I thank him for his desire to want to do what God wants him to do. Praise the Lord. But without further ado, we want to go ahead and bring Brother Mark Goodman to the pulpit. Amen. I want you to get behind him tonight. Don't sit there and stare at him. But get behind him. Clap your hands. Stand up. Say amen. Say praise the Lord. Amen. How many's going to get behind tonight?
Amen.
Praise God. Brother Mark.
Praise the Lord. Thankful to be right here, right now.
Amen.
In Brooksville, Florida, at a youth rally. Now, any rally that I've been to, it wasn't quiet.
Come on.
You ever been to a school rally? Those kids get with it. All right? Shouldn't be any different in the church.
Right.
We have more to be excited about. We have more to praise and worship about than, you know, the ones that think they got it all. And The bottom line is, the world thinks we're bound and we're crazy. I said it before. Kooks is the word I've been called here lately, and that kind of hit home. But I want to just be real quick. This is a youth rally. I want to say something that can pertain to the youth, but also to the older ones also. I've been bound before. It wasn't in church. It wasn't doing what the Lord wanted me to do. Being bound, I was on alcohol, trying to suppress my feelings. You know, that is being bound. Not coming to church, that's being bound. I would go to bed. Literally, I would drink, and I would try to drown my thoughts and stuff. Just because of the pressures of life, it got to me, and I failed the Lord, and I was trying to numb it all. I was trying to fix things myself instead of letting the Lord fix it, and I was bound because I would have my fun, but at night, I would sit there and cry all night. I wouldn't be able to get sleep. In my mind, I was battling a warfare that was... It was strong, you know, and I would cry and I would pray. I said, God, I'm not where I need to be, but please, you know, if you have a little bit more mercy for me, don't let me die like this. I'll be back. You know, I kept telling myself, I'll be back. I need to get back in church where I need to be. And it took me a little bit, but you know what? Whenever I came back and I gave my life back to God, then I felt the freedom again. And this world, they tell us that we're bound. They tell us that we're crazy. But let me tell you something. We are more free than they are, you know. And I don't know why I said that. That wasn't even part of my message. But I just want to share that with the youth. You know, kids in school, they don't want anything to do with you because you don't have anything to do with them. As far as, like, they're in their circle, they're smoking, they're cussing, they're drinking, you know. You're crazy if you're not part of them. They're the cool clique, you know. They want to bring you in. They want to drag you. And they want to take you and change you. Because, I don't know, they get some kind of sick pleasure out of it. But I just want to start off in Psalms 27. It says, the Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. On whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked, even mine enemies and my foes, come upon me to eat up my flesh, they stumbled and fell. How many times have you felt like the world's coming against you? Like you were all alone, there was nobody there for you, but you got this group of people that are coming against you, and whether it be friends, and sometimes, you know what, it's family that'll come against you. They'll doubt you. They'll talk falsely against you. They'll throw you in a pit like they threw Jacob. Has anybody been there, or is it just me, you know? I've been there recently. Not family, but thank God for my family being here. I love them very much. Dad, your father's gift is coming. Hasn't gotten his yet, Mike. Well, alrighty then, that took a turn. Though an host should encamp against me, my heart shall not fear. Though war should arise against me, in this will I be confident. So they're surrounding you. They want to throw you in a pit. That's okay. When the enemy's in front of you, when the enemy's behind you, and when the enemy's is on your sides, we just have to remember that there's a God above us taking care of it all. There's a God fighting the fight in front of us. And when we're fighting and following the Lord with the battle that's in front of us, guess what? He's behind us fighting the one that's coming up too. But hey, this is a kicker. We can't fight it ourselves. All right, how many prideful people do we have in here? And be honest, I like to fix things myself. I break something, all right, got to fix this. You know, something wrong going in my life, I try to fix it myself. You know, like I told you, I failed and I turned my back on God. You know why? Because I tried to deal with it myself. I tried to get the pain away. I tried to just cope with it all. And that's what happens when we deal with things ourselves. It's 60 degrees, 180, whatever it is. I'm not good at math. It's total 180 degrees from what the Lord wants us to do. And can anybody contend to that? You know, have you ever tried to fix your own problems? Did it work out? Or did it work out and it's exactly the outcome that you wanted it to be? Or how about if it worked out, but it seemed like down the road your problem got a little bit worse. It came back and your problem got a little bit worse. You know what? It's because you didn't let the Lord fight your battles. For it says, one thing I have desired of the Lord, that will I seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in his temple. For in this time of trouble he shall hide me in his pavilion. In the secret of his tabernacle shall he hide me. He shall set me upon a rock, and now shall mine head be lifted up above mine enemies round about me. Therefore will I offer in his tabernacle sacrifices of joy, and this is what I want to concentrate. I will sing, yea, I will sing praises unto the Lord. All right? You ever been to a ball game and the home team is losing? The crowd's silent when the team's losing. But you get a little spark of excitement, like in baseball. Somebody gets a hit or a home run or whatever, and it seems like there's a little bit of hope. The crowd starts getting into it. They start making a little bit of noise. It's called a momentum swing. All right? Same way in the church. If you want to lay down, let the devil win, don't say anything at all. Don't try to get a blessing in the service. Sit down in the seat. You'll get exactly what you expect. You know, but if you want to be a winner and an overcomer and be victorious over the trials and battles or whatever it is going on in your life, get up a little bit. You know what? The Lord will take care of it if you let him. You know, if you sit there, it's not doing you any good if you sit on the pew and you contemplate about it and you're sitting there all stressed out and, oh, please, Lord, you know. While all along, the Lord's prepared a blessing for you before you even got here. He wants to take it from you, but will you lay it down? All right? But you got to be willing to move. You got to be willing to speak. You got to be willing to praise. You got to be willing to make a little noise for the Lord. And that's basically what this message is titled. Make a little noise for the Lord. I want to go to Judges 7 and 12. I ain't got the iPad, so it's going to take me a little bit longer than the rest of the guys. Brother Paul said he's going to buy me one. Just kidding. 7 and 12. Now this is the battle of Gideon. All right. He got his men. In the beginning, he had 32,000 men going to face the Midianites and the Amalekites. I believe that's right. Actually, I know it's right. Okay, so he had 32,000 men. He was going to go to battle. They were going to take over the land. The Lord said to Gideon, he's like, tell the guys that whoever is afraid to leave right now. 32,000 basically, and paraphrasing for the Lord, he's like, I don't need 32,000 to beat these people. So all that were afraid left, and then there was left 10,000. So 22,000 people left because they were afraid. Then they went down, and he said, that's still too much. 10,000, still too much. You know, right here, the Lord's wanting to make an example of the enemy. You know, a lot of times it seems like you're overwhelmed. The enemy's all around you. And the Lord will do something, and you're like, well, Lord, how can any good become of this? Well, I mean, right here, he's getting more and more and more outnumbered. Needless to say, after they did the test at the water, they're left 300 men. And verse 12 says, and the Midianites and Amalekites and all the children of East lay along in the valley like grasshoppers for multitude. And their camels were without number as a sand by the seaside for multitude. And can you imagine looking into the valley and seeing all these people and knowing in the back of your mind that you only have 300 men and you're about to face this battle? You have to have some kind of trust in the Lord, some kind of faith. That, Lord, I don't know how this is going to go down, but I know whatever happens, you're in control. All right? I'm not in control. I'm going to obey. I'm going to follow you and trust that you're going to take care of this. I'm going somewhere. Just give me a few minutes. 19, it said, so Gideon and the 100 men that were with him came unto the outside of the camp in the beginning of the middle watch. And they had but newly set the watch, and they blew the trumpets and brake the pitchers that were in their hands. And the three companies blew the trumpets and brake the pitchers and held the lamps in their left hands and the trumpets in their right hands to blow withal. And they cried, the sword of the Lord and of Gideon. And they stood every man in his place round about the camp, and all the host ran and cried and fled. Y'all reading this? See, they're just making a bunch of noise and their enemies are running. It doesn't make sense to us. But to the Lord, he's got everything worked out. I mean, come on. Really? They didn't even have to lift a finger, so to speak. They didn't have to swing a sword. They just had to make a little bit of noise. You know, in our life, we don't have to do this great battle that we think we should be fighting or take care of it a certain way that we think it should be taken care of. All we got to do is come to church, give it to God, make a little noise, try to get your blessing, and lay it down, and the Lord will take care of it all. Amen. But we're human. Amen. If you're anything like me, you can preach this very message, and then the next trial that you go through, you try to deal with it yourself. All right? But I'm trying to get a point across. The Lord will take care of our needs. Yes, if we just follow him. That's follow him and give heed to the instruction that he's given us. Go to Joshua 6:14. Everybody knows about this, Joshua in Jericho. God had promised them a land, but paraphrasing here, the devil put up walls around their blessing. When we come to church, we automatically have a blessing. God's prepared a blessing for us, but it seems like a lot of times we always have this wall built up. It's like we've been hurt by life. Certain circumstances has hurt us so bad that we put up walls and we just want to sit there and just go through the motions and not really get what was promised to us and what is here for us. There's victory behind the walls. There's healing behind the walls. There's endless possibilities when it comes to the Lord behind the walls, but we have to do what it takes to get those walls down. And in Joshua 6:14-16, it says, in the second day they compassed the city once and returned into the camps. So they did 6 days. And it came to pass on the seventh day that they rose up early about the dawning of the day and compassed the city after the same manner 7 times. Only on that day they compassed the city 7 times. And it came to pass at the seventh time when the priests blew with the trumpets, Joshua said unto the people, shout, for the Lord hath given you the city. Now, we come into church. Now, I'm doing a lot of paraphrasing here, but when we come to church, like I said, we have a blessing, but it seems like we get hurt and beaten up so bad during the week. We were on fire just last service. But it seemed like towards the beginning of the service, people were, oh, I'm tired. You know what I mean? I'm not trying to preach at you and throw darts. That's not what I'm trying to do. I'm just trying to make a point. It's like We let the world beat us down so much. We have time to stay up till 1 o'clock in the morning watching a hockey game, shouting and screaming at the TV, whether it's good or bad. It was a lot of bad for me. But we'll sit there and we'll spend all that time getting into that and screaming and hollering for our teams. But when we come to church, it's we just sit here and we go through the motions and we listen to the songs. We listen to the preacher and we go home. And you know what that's doing? That's making us really weak. That's making us, you know, every time the devil comes in during the middle of the week when everyone's away, that's giving your temptation a little bit more of a chance to actually sink in. We give in to temptations. Because you know what? We're not coming to church and getting the blessings that we need or the uplifting that we need. We start getting depressed and there seems like there's no hope for our trials. We're not getting over anything. Things are just piling up. Anybody been there where they just, things piling up on you? You don't feel like there's any reason to come to church. The Lord's not for you. Have I been the only one that felt like the Lord was not for me? You know? And I've been to the place where I was completely numb. I would even try to feel the Lord. But because of my hurt, because of the walls that I built up, I couldn't feel the Lord when the Lord was moving. But I purposed in my mind, there was a service. I like I said, I totally given up on church. I was like, there's nothing for me. I backslided. I was like, I'm done with church. Well, then there was a man, Troy Lee. And he's like, man, you done giving up on church. He's like, just come to church with me. Try Brother Steve's out just this once. He's like, just come with me, you know. And so I did it, and I came, and I liked what I felt. And I felt like a little bit of my wall was broken down, just a little bit. You know, I came on a mission. I was like, I'm going to try one more time. I tried tons of times before, but it wasn't my seventh time. All right? They walked around Jericho six times, but the seventh time the walls came down. It wasn't my seventh time. And then the next service went on, and I felt a little bit more freedom. I felt a little bit more of the Lord dealing with me, and I was like, I'm liking what I feel, you know? And then I purposed in my mind about 4 days before service, and I was talking to Paul. I said, you know what? I feel the Lord, you know, a little bit. But I want to be surrounded and engulfed in a blessing because I hadn't felt it in so long. And I came on a mission, so to speak, to that service. And we sang a couple of songs, and I felt the Lord starting to move. And no one else was moving. No one else was at the altar, but I felt like I needed to go down to the altar and try one more time. And I went down to the altar, and I raised my hands up, and I made a little bit of noise. And lo and behold, the walls that I had put up in my life, the numbness that formed against me and around me, they all fell down. The walls fell down. But you know what? They didn't fall down because I sat on the pew. They didn't fall down because I sat there and I was stressing out and said, Lord, take care of it. The Lord was taking care of it, but he wanted me to act a little bit. You know, the Lord will take care of things, but you have to be willing to act upon what the Lord wants you to do. All right? The Lord's not just going to give you a job. Lord's just not going to give you a blessing without you seeking for it or trying to reach for him. You have to reach out. You have to go down to the altar and try. You know, no matter how many times that you did it before and was unsuccessful, your seventh time is coming. You have to be willing to come down here and lay it down right here and not pick it back up and purpose in your mind, Lord, I'm giving it all to you. I don't care what you want me to do. I don't care how you're going to take care of it. But Lord, I trust you. Oh, I trust you. Take it from me. And that's what I did. And you know what? It wasn't long. I started shouting. I started moving a little bit. Woo! I started feeling the Lord move in my life. Let me tell you something. I was sat down as a minister. Look, I'm ministering right now. The Lord is restored. Whoa, the world took everything away from me, but the Lord gave it back tenfold. He took friends away from me. The world took everything away from me. But look what I have now. many times the world wants to take things away from you, make you think you got nothing, make you think that you're worthless, make you think that you're so far in a pit that you can't get pulled out. But let me tell you something, with a little bit of determination and a little bit of faith and trust in the Lord, you know the scriptures I've been reading, all it says is make a little bit of noise and follow the Lord's leading and he'll take care of everything. But you got to be willing. You got to be willing to let go. You got to be willing to say, Lord, you know, I trust you. Things are going crazy for me. But I know no matter what it looks like, no matter how outnumbered I am in this life, that you'll take care of my trials and my burdens and my giants in my life for me. It says it in the Word. In Psalms 30 and 5, it says, weeping may endure for a night, but joy cometh in the morning. You know, we are a blessed people. We really are. The Lord's done so much for us. If you're really, truly, honestly serving the Lord, you ain't going without. You may think you're going without, but you're not really going without. We get into the place where we're so discouraged and we're sick of getting beat up and we're sick of going through things, and we just, sometimes you just got to cry. Yeah. All right? But there's a time for joy. There's a time that you need to stand up and quit giving the devil victory. Right. All right? There's a time for that. We give the devil too much credit. I mean, trust me, you get it at work, you get it at school, you get it at home, you get it in the going to Walmart, they look at you funny, they snarl against you. The friends that you did have, they'll put their nose in the air, act like you're not even there. Anybody been there? Well, let me tell you something. Joy cometh in the morning. But like I said, you got to be willing to let it go. You got to be willing to say, Lord, they're doing what they're doing, but I need to do what I need to do. I need to do what you have me to do. Let me see what I got. Got Psalms 150. One through six. It says, praise ye the Lord, praise God in his sanctuary. Praise him in the firmament of his power. Praise him in his mighty acts. Praise him according to the excellent greatness. Praise him with the sound of the trumpet. Praise him with the psaltery and harp. Praise him with the timbrel and dance. Praise him with stringed instruments and organs. Praise him upon the loud cymbals. Praise him upon the high sounding cymbals. Let everything that hath breath praise the Lord. Praise ye the Lord. I think that what that chapter's trying to say is you're supposed to praise the Lord. Do y'all think that's what it's saying? I don't think it could get any more clearer than that. People are like, I just don't understand the Bible. Well, right here it says, praise ye the Lord about 100 times in 6 verses. You know, you got to be willing to come to church. Why do you come to church? If you're just going to sit there, why do you come to church? You're not here by chance. Yeah, is it because you just want to see everybody and see what they're wearing and smell their cologne? No, that's not me. I come to church because I'm looking for something. I'm hungry for something. I want to take advantage of what the Lord has given us. He died so that we could live and have it more abundantly. I've been there, church. And I'm not trying to preach a discouraging message. I'm not. I'm trying to tell you what it takes to get past all the hurt and all the struggle and all the trials and stuff. It's not easy. It's not easy. Serving the Lord, anybody that says serving the Lord, the rules of serving the Lord is easy, but because the world is the way it is, the world makes it hard on us. Because you're the minority, you're the crazy ones, you're the kooks, you're the brainwashed people, you know? That's what everyone says that we are. And if you've ever been in the school system, I mean, you basically are way outnumbered. They pushed the Lord straight out of school, and all these devil-filled people wearing their devil shirts and they want to talk about different spells and stuff like that. That's allowed, but as soon as you talk about the Lord, you're expelled or kicked out of school. It doesn't make sense. All right, so we are beat up. And I keep saying beat up because you know what? I've been there. It seems like you didn't have a leg to stand on, and as soon as you start sticking up for yourself and getting back up, they knock you right back down. But just trust the Lord. Come to church. Lay it all down. Give it all to Him, and I guarantee you He'll take care of it. Amen. All right? Young, old, whatever. It goes for all of you. Because to tell you the truth, we got a lot to fight for. And I really appreciated Paul's message. It's something to fight for. It's if you can't fight for anything on the earth, fight for what's to come. Amen. You know, this world, they don't get it. They think that they're just going to live their life how they want to live it, and then they're going to die and it's going to be over. No, there's a place called hell, people. Amen. All right? And I don't want to go there. We're gnashing of teeth and worms, and I don't want to go to hell where there's child molesters and alcoholics and murderers and all that. I don't want to go there. That's not something that I want to do. But there's a place that's promised to me. The streets of gold and gates of pearl and a throne and a river that flows from the throne, and there's a tree of life and a mansion. And all I have to do is follow a little bit of rules and get made fun of a little bit along the way. I think that's worth it. You get one chance at life. You get one chance. And if you play your cards right and you do everything that you're supposed to, you'll be able to live for eternity in heaven. But if you gamble your cards and you think, well, I got plenty of time, I'm going to live fun right now, and I know what I'm supposed to do, but I'm going to wait. I'm going to wait till the time's right. And who's to say that you're going to make it tomorrow? Who's to say? And I've been recently in a car wreck. Who's this? I'm 21 years old. I'm supposed to have a full life ahead of me, and I still do by the grace of God. But just like that, you can get T-boned and taken out of this world. You know, that's something that kind of clicked in my head, you know. I can't live life like I want to. I can't fit in with the crowd because just like that, I can be taken out. Amen. In a moment, in a twinkling of an eye, it could be over. Yep. We're not promised tomorrow. We have to make sure that we're doing exactly what we need to do according to the Bible. And when we get a chance, come and lay all our burdens down. It'll be a lot easier if you listen. The Bible tells us all over the place that He'll take care of it for us if we just let Him. Amen. All right. As you can tell, I was really nervous tonight. I heard a preacher say that he was so nervous that he could thread a sewing machine while it was running. And that's basically how I feel. But that's what the Lord given to me. And just pray for me. You know, like I said, Megan, Cameron, Jared, I'm searching for young people right now. No matter what they say, you're not what they say. You're more than what they have to say about you. You're more than what they think that you are. I'll say one last thing. I was at work one time, and this atheist came up, and she was like, "I don't believe in the Lord. I don't know why you do. There's so much bad things happening in this world, babies dying, and what's the Lord get out of that? You know, there can't be a Lord. You know, that you talk about this graceful, merciful God, but yet all this bad is happening." And I sat there and I told her, I was like, "Listen, if the Lord came down and intervened in literally everyone's needs, we'd be a spoiled people." And she's like, "Well, how can you prove that there's a Lord?" And I was like, "Well, through personal experiences and going to church, and I can feel them." And she's like, "Feel them? Like, that doesn't make sense." And I was like, "All right, well, let me tell you something that'll make sense a little bit more." And I said, "Do you believe in oxygen or air?" And she said, "Yeah." And we were medics, so we obviously would believe in oxygen. She's like, "Yeah, I believe in oxygen." I said, "Can you see it?" She's like, "No." I said, "Exactly." And she said, "Exactly what?" I said, "Well, you can't see God, but you can feel God when you need it. When you actually try, the Lord will show Himself to you." And she sat there and she had nothing to say. And she's like, "Well, what if you're wrong? What if you live your life, like you said, you're so strict and you don't get to do go out and have fun and go to the bars and blah, 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 blah. What if you get up there and there's nothing? What if you die and that's it? I was like, well, then really, honestly, I haven't lost anything. But I said, let me ask you a question. And I've heard this said several times before, but it was perfect. I was on a roll with this lady. I was like, I'm going to tell her about the Lord. And I was like, let me ask you something. If you live the life that you're living and want to, and you live lavishly and pridefully, and you don't believe in the Lord, and you die, and you go to heaven, and you find out that there is a heaven and a hell, what have you lost? What have you gained? You've literally lost everything. If I live this life the way that I feel is right and the way the Bible says is right, and I find out that there's not, which there is, I've lost nothing. I'm still living a good life. Amen. All right? So just y'all pray for me.
Night. Praise the Lord. Sometimes it just takes a little bit of noise. Anybody ever, besides me, ever all of a sudden just yeah, sometimes you just gotta Dad does it all the time, I know. Don't he, Mom? That woman. Ah! I feel the rain. I feel the rain falling down on me. Oh, I feel the rain. I feel the rain falling down on me. Former ain't the latter ain't together. I'm not talking about the weather. The Holy Ghost rain, it's falling down on me. Oh, I feel the rain. I feel the rain. It's falling down on me. Oh, I feel the rain. I feel the rain falling down on me. The former rain, the latter rain together. Oh, I'm not talking about the weather. It's the Holy Ghost rain, it's falling down on me. Oh, yes, I feel the rain. I feel the rain falling down on me. Oh, I feel the rain. I feel the rain falling down on me. Oh, the former rain, the latter rain together. I'm not talking about the weather. The Holy Ghost rain, it's falling down on me. Well, the former rain, the latter rain together. I'm not talking about the weather. It's the Holy Ghost rain, it's falling down on me. Praise God. Give the Lord a hand clap. He's worthy. Any announcements to be made tonight? Any announcements?